Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad, and welcome to the second video on C++ programming language. In the previous video, we have seen what exactly is C++. We have seen when it was created, why it was created. You know, we have seen the history of the C++ programming language. In this video, we will see some of the terms used with a programming language, and then we're gonna see the advantages of learning the C++, and then we will see where exactly the C++ programming language is used in this real world. First, let's take a look at some of the terms used with the programming language. So the first term is the general purpose programming language. A general purpose programming language is a language designed to be used for writing the softwares in a wide variety of application domains. In simple words, when we say a programming language as a general purpose programming language, it means that we can use that programming language to create different variety of applications. The C++ is also a general purpose programming language. It means you can use it for creating different types of softwares or the programs. Now, the next thing is C++ is a middle level language. We have divided the programming languages in three categories: lower level languages, high level languages, and middle level languages. Lower level languages allow us to directly interact with the machine. The machine level code and the assembly level languages come under this lower level language category. And then we have the higher level languages, where a programmer can easily write the programs in a language which is almost similar to the human readable format. The higher level languages offer a lot of built-in features. The programmer can use those features and easily write the programs. Then we have another category called as the middle level languages, where some programming languages offer the features of the higher level languages and also the features of the lower level languages. The C++ programming language comes in the category of the middle level languages. Here, you know, if a programming language belongs to higher level language or lower level language or middle level language, it doesn't really mean that that programming language is good or bad. Every programming language has its own pros and cons. Now, the next thing is the compiled language. The thing is, C++ is the middle level language, and the code written using the C++ programming language is much closer to the human readable format. You know, we can easily read the code and we can understand what exactly is going on. But the computers, on the other hand, they can only understand the code written in the form of zeros and ones. In other words, the machine code. So what we have to do is, first we have to write the program in the C++, and then we have to convert that code to the machine level form. Here uses the compiler to convert the code to the machine form. And this process of converting the code using the compiler is called as the compilation method. Since this uses the compilation method, it is called as the compiled language. Now, the next thing is the object-oriented programming language. We have talked about this in the previous video also. C++ uses a new programming approach called as the object-oriented programming approach. Since it uses this programming approach, it is called as the object-oriented programming language. In C++, we can do four types of programming. One is the procedural programming. You know, it is the way we program using the C programming language. Another one is the object-oriented programming. And then we can do the generic programming using the templates. And then we have the functional programming. This functional programming is newly added to the C++ programming language. C++ is a general purpose, middle level, compiled, object-oriented programming language. Alright, now let's take a look at some of the advantages of learning the C++ programming language. So the first thing is, C++ itself is a very efficient language. The code written using the C++ programming language will run efficiently. And also the code written using the C++ will be reliable and it will run fast. Now, the next thing is, if you learn the C++ programming language, you will be learning these different programming approaches. So you will have the better understanding of the most of the programming approaches, specifically the object-oriented programming approach. You will be learning the concepts like the classes, objects, inheritance, polymorphism, all these things. And I think C++ is one of the best language to learn this object-oriented programming approach. So the advantage of this is, once you learn this C++, then if you want to move to some other languages like Java or C#, then it will be a lot more easy, because this Java and C#, they also use the object-oriented programming approach. So you will find it easy to learn those languages. All right, now, finally, let's take a look at where exactly this C++ programming language is widely used. As we have seen before, C++ is a general purpose programming language. So it means that it can be used to create different variety of applications. C++ is widely used for creating the games. Most of the games you see nowadays have a majority of the code written using the C++. Then it is used for creating the graphical user interface based applications. You know, you can use it where the user can interact with the computer using the buttons, you know, menus and all those. In those kind of applications also you can use the C++. And then C++ is also used in the image editing softwares like the Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, ImageReady. And C++ is also used for creating the web browsers. For example, the Mozilla Firefox has the most of the code written using the C++. And then C++ is also used for creating the compilers. And then C++ is also used for writing the major parts of the operating systems like OS X or the Windows. And C++ is also used for medical and engineering applications. And you guys may have seen that, you know, some of the simulation softwares and also some of the softwares used in the medical field are written using the C++. Another area where C++ is widely used is for creating or writing the other programming languages. For example, the Java programming language is written using the C++ programming language. So this is it, guys. This is about some information on some of the programming terms used with the C++, and also some information on the advantages of learning the C++ and where the C++ is widely used in the real world. Now, if you don't have the proper understanding of the concepts like the programming languages, the types of programming languages, and the compilation method, the interpretation method, then I have a video which explains all those things in detail. So I'm gonna put the link of that video in the description box so you guys can check it out. And this is it, guys. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, then give a thumbs up. If you don't like it, then give a thumbs down and write your opinion in the comment box. And if you want to watch more tutorials, then do subscribe to my channel. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.